Focus. We're here. I see you. We're here. We are here mentally. To be very honest, I have a lot of unpopular opinions about this show. Zuko should have been with Katara because they were the best couple ever and they had the most chemistry compared to Katara and Aang. Aang should have honestly just had like millions of concubines and just like slept with a bunch of women so he can repopulate the world with airbenders instead of just having one wife. I think he should have held out and tried to save his people that way, but that's again my unpopular opinion. Let me just backtrack into what made me want to start this idea in the first place. America is essentially the Fire Nation. What is up, my beautiful people? Welcome back to my channel. I'm your girl, That's Otaku, and in this corner of the world, we like to believe that animated characters are way better than actual human beings. So, if you are new here, welcome to the family. Please consider subscribing, liking this video, sharing it with your friends so you can be all part of this crazy little family that we are trying to make bigger and bigger. Now, for today's video, we're going to talk about one of my favorite shows. We're going to talk about Avatar: The Last Airbender. Not the one with the blue people, not that Avatar. Avatar The Last Airbender, the one that people keep debating is either an anime or a cartoon, but we all know it's a cartoon because it was made in Japan. If you weren't on the Avatar bandwagon back in 2005 to 2008 when it aired, then you probably recently joined the fandom as of right now because it has been put on Netflix. So now we can have a bunch of new people join the fandom. And isn't that really great? Isn't that really special? Now, if you're looking back at the show, you can probably see that watching it as an adult is very different from when you were watching it as a child. When you're an adult, you're kind of seeing that there's a lot of underlying themes, some dark themes, whether it's about the difficulties of war, about famine, about fighting, about politics, about propaganda. There are so many different elements that the writers brought into the show that you now look back and you're just like, hold up, this shit's low-key woke. And I was also having those feelings. I was re-watching the series like a couple weeks ago. Watched it in 3 days, one season per day, 3 seasons. I was very tired. But as a quick synopsis, you have Avatar The Last Airbender. Avatar Aang, he's an airbender. He's one of the last airbenders on the planet, and he's also the Avatar. So he can bend all four elements. And the four elements are earth, water, air, and fire. Whole world has been in war for about 100 years. Aang's trying to defeat the Fire Lord and try to stop this war. What started all of this fighting and conflict in the first place? And that is where we get season 3, episode 6 about Sozin and what happened. Now, what we learn about in that episode is that Fire Lord Sozin, who was the one that started the whole war in the first place, he was best friends with Avatar Roku. Avatar Roku was the predecessor to Avatar Aang. They were part of the Fire Nation, they were best friends, boom, bam, bam. Fire Lord Sozin had the idea that the Fire Nation was so great, so wealthy, so powerful, that they had to share this wealth and prosperity with the rest of the world. That was the root of his ideology in terms of why he wanted to start the war in the first place. Now, of course, Avatar Roku, who bends all four elements and supposed to keep peace within the world, he was like, nah, I think the four nations should stay four. This is not what we're supposed to do. We're not supposed to go ahead and intrude on other people's territory because you need all four to create some type of balance. You cannot have one out of balance because then that'll send the whole world out of whack. But Sozin was like, how dare you think that our country is not great enough to be able to spread our wealth and knowledge to everybody else? Why would you want to stand in the way of that? Are you not Fire Nation first? Fire Lord Sozin has a lot of the mentality that a lot of Americans have. Not all, of course, but when you look at the state of American politics, we do not shy away from going to other countries, spreading our ideas of democracy, but then what happens is that we're just toppling down upon a bunch of people's governments, putting in place dictatorships and leaders that will coincide with what we think because we're the big bullies of this planet. That's essentially what we are. And that brings me to the point of this video. America is the Fire Nation. The Fire Nation is America. The people that created Avatar were trying to warn us. They were like, y'all better watch this country because if we don't get ourselves back in order, we could very well end up like that. You can go into and say that when Azula went into the Earth Kingdom Nation, the Ba Sing Se, when she went to the capital of the Earth Kingdom Nation and completely took down the Dai Li agents and turned the Dai Li agents' loyalty onto the Fire Nation, you could even say that that's pretty much foreshadowing or like similar to how we go around into these countries, infiltrate their governments, and have their governments instead serve us instead of the people that they are meant to be serving. Now, I could go on to this big old rant and continue to talk more about America has gone around and dismantled a bunch of countries and spread its own ideas of diversity and prosperity and being like, oh, we're number one. We're just trying to help the entire world when we're really not. I don't know any other country except really Haiti, and I'm still learning about that as much. It's very similar to how America went around and spread their ideologies and their helping hand to Haiti. Because in case you didn't know, which a lot of people don't, Haiti and America do have a lot of shared history together. When Haiti got their independence back in 1804, America was shook. America was straight up shook. They were like, how the hell did this country of black slaves topple France and then gain its own independence? If the slaves can do that in that country, in Haiti, what's to say that they're not going to try to do that in America? What's to say that our own slave system is not going to be able to stick around and we're going to be overturned as well? So they were absolutely scared. America and a bunch of other European countries, but America we're talking about, was absolutely shook when Haiti got its independence. And ever since then, America has been bitter and has done everything in their power to try to undo that independence and try to enforce its own idealism and control over this country that was full of black slaves. I'm saying that right now because that's exactly what happened. The way that America exerted its power and tried to spread its ideologies onto Haiti was mainly through the US occupation of Haiti from 1915 all the way up until 1934. Now, this was started by President Woodrow Wilson, who had this idea or had this reputation of being a liberal and wanting everyone to have fairness, and that was kind of like his whole campaign. But except when it came to Haiti, he was like, nah, we're not about to let this black country of slaves try to tell us what and try to get their own independence and all that stuff. We were already an independent country for 100 years at this point, but America thought, let us try to help this country that is struggling, because at the time Haiti was going through some political unrest, because unfortunately due to the French, we didn't really get much of an infrastructure of a proper government. So that's kind of what led to Haiti being in the state that it is today. But America had a hand in our downfall. America was like, I bet. I see that the Haitians are struggling. I see that they are not completely all together with their shit. Let's try to go in and try to fix it. Let's try to lend a helping hand. You have Woodrow Wilson going in 1915 with the US Marines being occupied there. You had them seizing $500,000 at the time and holding it in New York to try to manage Haiti's money. And then on top of that, you have Woodrow Wilson trying to change the constitution of Haiti. Now, when Haiti got its first constitution back in the 1800s, they specifically wanted to make sure that no other foreign country could own land in Haiti, because they wanted to maintain their independence as much as possible. What did America go and do? They went and tried to undo that constitution by making a clause saying that other people from other countries can go in and own land. The Haitian people were completely against that and did not want that to happen. But what happened was Woodrow Wilson decided to put in their own figurehead, Philippe Souze d'Antiguenot. We're just gonna say that because I'm terrible at names. I can't say names at all. But they put in this figurehead president that did not have Haitian people's intention at heart. This president was essentially a figurehead, a puppet. Kind of like how when Ba Sing Se had the king of Ba Sing Se was like the figurehead of the people and didn't really have any proper control, but the Dai Li agents were controlling all of the Earth Kingdom. Kind of like that, but the Americans decided to put in a Haitian so it can be like, oh, see, we have a Haitian president that's here for the people, but he's secretly going to be doing whatever he wants. Hence why he went around and campaigned for the dissolution of the legislature that would keep that clause in the constitution to make sure that nobody would own land. From the pressure of America, America made sure that president adhered to the ideals of America for the best interests at heart. So now what do you have? You have America having the right to essentially come in and help Haiti whenever they see fit, and taking control of their money, their land, their power, and pretty much everything. Now, what does that sound like to you? Doesn't that sound a little bit kind of like how Azula went in, took over the Dai Li agents, and completely made sure that Ba Sing Se could adhere to whatever the Fire Nation would see fit? That's why they took over the entire Earth Kingdom. You see the connections that I'm trying to make here? Uncle Otto was saying that you cannot be doing this because the world will be at war with itself and the world will not have its own sense of balance. When the Fire Nation decided to spread its ideology to the Airbenders, the whole Airbender Nation was wiped out. And now Ba Sing Se, which is the biggest city and the biggest part of the Earth Kingdom, is no longer Earth Kingdom territory. It's now being just another spot for Fire Nation. So that whole goodwill that they were going into completely went to shit because no one gained any good from this. Even Zuko himself said, that was such a brilliant lie. The whole world doesn't see our greatness. They hate us. That's exactly what's going on with America. The whole world does not see America's greatness. They hate us. And rightfully so. We're known to be a bully country. We're known to be toppling governments, putting in our foot in people's mouths when we're not supposed to, getting into other countries' business. And now we have the reputation of just being the big loudmouth bully that didn't really do anything to help the world in the end of the day. Such a disappointing thing that so many of these white countries and other countries do not see our greatness, and they have to do everything they are in their power to tear that apart. It started with America being afraid of a slave rebellion within their own country, and then it ended with them still to this day impeding their own ideologies and their own interests at heart at the expense of Haitian people. Now, the point of what I'm trying to say is you have to look at your country's history. We can have all this pride within our country and be happy that we're Americans and all that stuff. I'm happy I'm an American to some extent. Like, I've been born here, I've lived here, I was raised here, I'm making a future for myself here. But it's also important to analyze your country's history, to get a bigger picture for what our country is so you can better be able to help it heal in the future. Zuko learned that lesson himself. He had such nationalism for his country, but then when he took the time to see what his country has done to the other nations, what the Fire Nation did to the earth, the air, and the water tribes, all those other people were affected by the Fire Nation's rule. He learned that for himself, and he decided to change his mind for the betterment of the Fire Nation, not at the detriment of the Fire Nation, but to make the Fire Nation better. And that's exactly what Americans need to spend time doing more of. They need to analyze themselves to see where in our country's history were we wrong? Because no country's perfect. Where in our country's history were we at a disservice to other people? Where were we being tyrannical dictators? Where were we putting ourselves in places where we had no business? Once we analyze that part of our history, make sure to pay attention to when it's happening in current events so it doesn't happen again, we as a country can move forward and go towards having more peace within the world. Just like in Avatar, where Zuko wanted to have more peace within the four nations. That's pretty much all I have to say. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for watching. Please consider subscribing to my channel. Please consider sharing this with your friends, liking this video, spread the word about my family over here, and we can just, you know, get more people to join the family and all that stuff. So thank you again, and I will see you next time. Bye.